Welcome in this video lesson, and here we're going to see another special chess move, the chess move called en passant. It's a French term and it means in passing. And in previous lesson we learned how to move the pawns, and when the pawns are in their initial squares, for example white pawns are standing in the second rank and black pawns are standing in the seventh rank. White pawn can move forward. He can go on b3, for example. He can move forward one square. Nonetheless, it can move forward two squares as well. And this is some basic moves that pawns can do. And let's imagine that black player will play something, and now white pawn will move forward one square again. And we can imagine here a line that crossed the table in two parts. It's white's side. This the first four ranks are white side, and the other side is black side. And here white pass the middle of the board. He pushed his pawn forward, and it passed the middle of the board. Now it's black's turn. Black of course can play the move c6, and now as we learn, white pawn can move forward one square. It can go on b6, or it can capture the pawn on c6. We can take the pawn and capture this c6 pawn. However, black can use the special move that pawns have, and it can move forward two squares because it's standing in their initial position, right? So it can move forward two squares, and now it is something like stealing white, stealing a move. It's not like avoiding the capturing, right? And this is not fair because it looked like that black steal something and can move forward very fast in the other side of the board. And here we have this special rule: when black pawn move two squares ahead, and right now white have the opportunity to capture this pawn, capture on c6, and we can imagine that this pawn had moved only one square, and we can capture it like that. We can capture the pawn, take the pawn, put it on c6, and then we can remove the pawn from c5, and this is en passant. This is the special move, and it can happen only if we cross the middle, the white pawn cross the middle, and the other side played two moves ahead, his pawn from c7 to c5, and only in this move we can capture the pawn here on c6, and this is en passant. Imagine that black played the move c5, and white didn't capture the pawn. He can play another move like king h7, and after that black can move again, and now I don't have the opportunity to capture here en passant because I can move it only in the right move, in the move when black played c5. Now I can only go forward on b6, sorry. And let's see another example here. Here black can play this move d5, move forward his pawn two squares. White king is moving. I eliminate the boards that have only few pieces in order to understand this move clearly. And black can play this move d4. He crossed the center, right? He's in white side right now. And here white can play this move c4. Try to steal black, to say, okay, I'm trying to avoid this exchange. And the rules, in order to be fair, they are saying, okay, black can capture this pawn, we can take this pawn from d4, put it on c3 and leave it there, and after that to remove the pawn from c4. This is en passant rule. So let's try to see some examples now. This is my game, and just try to follow the game, and I'll try to show you the power of the pawn. So d4, d5, c4, c6, knight c3, knight f6, knight f3, h6. This is not a very good move because in the opening we should develop the pieces because the pieces can perform stronger attacks, and for that reason it's important to develop the pieces first of all. And you can see that I followed this rule and I played this move bishop to f4, bishop f5, and now queen b3. And now this is a very important moment for us because white queen is threatening this pawn on b7. This pawn is unprotected and we would like to capture it for free. For that reason, black played the move. He played his queen here on d7 and he is trying to protect this b7 pawn. However, I continue attacking and chasing away the queen. I played my move here on e5. The knights are moving in L shape and now I'm trying to capture the queen, and the queen is more powerful piece. For that reason, he should retreat in threats. He played this move, queen c8, a logical move. And a logical move because, as I see it right now, this is more complicated that I'm going to provide. If he went here, then I have a very unexpected tactic because I can play on g6. And now my knight from here is attacking the rook, the unprotected rook. It protects the bishop on f4, and this bishop is attacking the queen. So everything is not working well for black, and for that reason he tried to play a more safe move. He moved on c8, but after that I captured on d5. Now he realized that he cannot just recapture because he's losing a pawn. For example, if he captures here, he takes d5, knight takes d5. Now white have two pieces here, two attackers on d5, and black have only one, and for that reason I can capture on d5, knight takes d5 and queen takes d5. And you can pause the video and calculate the material here, and white is just a pawn up. The d pawn is an extra pawn. For that reason he tried to play something else. He played this queen d8 move, and he's trying to overprotect this d5, and he would like to recapture back to protect the pawn. And maybe after this exchange, d takes c6, maybe he had in mind to capture here on d4. However, now white have another threat, and he is threatening the f7 pawn because his knight and queen is aiming this pawn. And for that reason, before do anything else, he tried to play an intermediate move to attack the queen first and then to recapture the pawn on c6. And now you can see the power of the pawns. This pawn goes on c4 now, capture on d5 on c6, and white is not forced to move back the queen, but we can recapture on b7 with the pawn. He captured my queen, and as we learn, I capture here on a8 and I promote it to a new queen. And now I have a new queen of the board. White have two pawns, two extra pawns, and a rook. For that reason, my opponent resigned here. Let's move forward. This is another very nice example, and here white played this very good move, h5. I don't know who composed this position. Probably it's a fixed position. And the problem for black here is if he just moves the king, if he plays here on h4, then white can deliver a checkmate. What is checkmate? When we are threatening the enemy king, and the enemy king doesn't have any legal move. For that reason, black didn't play there, and he can play this move g6. But white here can capture h takes g6, and he can perform another checkmate with another piece. We are attacking the king with this rook. The rook is the king is in a beam of action, in a beam of black rooks, and cannot do anything now. He doesn't have any legal move, and for that reason, after h5, black can try another clever move here, and he can play g5. He is attacking the king, and he would like to keep close the h-file. What are you going to do here with white? It's white's turn. And white can capture en passant, because as you can see, white pawn crossed the middle and black just played this pawn two squares forward. And for that reason, white can capture here en passant. h takes g6, and we can remove this pawn and we can reveal the attack in the h-file. So let's move forward. I'd like to show you another game. And here it's a game from two amateur players, and the position is more complicated, and it's a real fight. And in order to understand this rule, I'm providing the next two exams in order to understand it clearly. And here black just played this move f5. What are you going to do now with white? And white can capture this pawn on this pawn f5 with this move en passant, because this the g pawn crossed the board. He played two moves and one more. He crossed this this line, this the middle of the board, and black just played this move forward two squares. And for that reason, after f5, we can capture on g6 like that. I capture the pawn and put it on f6. I leave it there, and I'm removing the f5 pawn. So let's move on to the next example. Here it's a game, a very recent game on 2020, and white player is Din Liren against Yu Jianyi. And black player played here b5. He is trying to attack the rook, and it's white's turn. What are you going to do here with white? And the best move here is to recapture a takes b6. Because we crossed the middle and he just played two moves forward, and for that reason we can capture on b6. Now black cannot recapture with the pawn because we can capture for free. The rook is for free and white is have more material here, and black is forced to recapture with a knight, and then we can play rook a6, for example. And we will learn later that these pawns on a7 and c6 are isolated, and this is not very good. White can press. However, during the game, Din Liren here, he didn't play this move, a takes b6, but he just removed the rook in its initial square on a1. Din Liren lost the game. Probably it was one of the reasons to lose the game, because he didn't capture on b6. And the point is to illustrate that we have this move and understand very clearly this rule en passant, the French term. And here is the example again. And if we cross the middle, and if black plays this pawn forward two squares, I have the opportunity to capture this pawn like it was on c6, something like that. I hope you enjoy this lesson. Please try to see it again, understand very very clearly what is this en passant rule. I didn't make any examples because it's a little more difficult to find good examples on en passant. But it's important to understand it and put it, implement it, perform it in your games. Thank you very much.